How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? This is my regular Thursday blog. Now, you probably thought that I'm going to talk about politics because that's what I always talk about. But politics is not the only thing in the world. There are things that have political influences and affect your life, even though it's not explicitly politics. It's not a Democrat or Republican issue. I'm talking about the issue that permeates our whole atmosphere, that made us lose our freedom of speech. People talk that you say you can't say whatever you want in a dictatorship. That's why we're so lucky that we live in a free country. We don't live in a free country. We live in a free country if you want to keep your mouth shut. Once you start talking, you're already in trouble. You ever try to say something about black people, even if it's a compliment? As soon as you say the word black, you have to start hiding and everybody starts looking around. White people are in a state of shock and panic as soon as they say the word black. And they look at the furniture between the chairs on the tables to make sure a black person didn't hear what they had to say. Now let's be honest about it. When black people talk about whites, do they get nervous? They don't get nervous. Why? Because they were once persecuted, as if they're being persecuted now. Nobody is persecuting a black person now. No black person is in danger of walking any street in America. I know a lot of streets where a white person wouldn't walk if he thinks there's black people there at 4 o'clock in the morning, but could you picture a black person saying 4 o'clock in the morning, watch out, let's not walk there, it's a Jewish neighborhood. You can get killed there, there's too many Gentiles. No, black people are not nervous. People say, oh, that you're politically incorrect. There's certain things that it's only politically incorrect if you're a white Protestant American Gentile. Then everything you say is politically incorrect. If you're black, if you're a Muslim, if you're a minority, even if you're a Jew, or if you're a short, fat person, any kind of minority. Women are also considered a minority. How they became a minority, nobody knows. They got a big mouth. They persecute men all over this country. And every time a man opens his mouth, he's in a panic because a woman might charge him immediately with sexual harassment. You don't even know what you said. You don't even know what you did. You just happened to look at a woman. Aha, you were stalking. You turned around, you were frocking. You were clawking, hawking, mocking. They got to wait for you no matter what you do. Every time a man sees a woman, he gets panicky and nervous. I better not look. I better not sit. Maybe she shouldn't find out that I'm in the neighborhood. And they get so nervous, they get paralyzed, and they can't move for an hour. Why? Because of political correctness. Is there political correctness for white Protestant American Gentiles? You ever see anybody nervous about what they say or do to a tall white American man? You can tell him to drop dead. You know what they'll say? It's up to you. He's too frightened to get involved or to get nervous. He doesn't want to get involved with anybody or anything. Muslims could say anything they want about Americans. This is the worst country in the world. They say filthy things about Jews every day. But could you ever say anything against a Muslim? Could you print anything? There was a cartoon about a Muslim. You can't even print a cartoon about a Muslim. They could tell you to drop dead. They'll burn down your building, your houses, your furniture, your clothes. They'll destroy your family, your buildings. They'll do everything. But if you print a cartoon, you go into a state of shock and you get so nervous you can't even walk in the street for a month. And maybe they'll make a jihad against you for the rest of your life. And you'll never be able to get out of your house till you pass away. Why? Because of political correctness. Let's be honest about it. The only people that can do what they please are tall, white, Protestant, American Gentiles. You can't say nothing about a woman. You can't say anything about a black. Do you know that you can't even mention work to a woman in the workplace? Because work is considered sexual harassment. You're allowed to hire her, and that's it. Whether she works or not, none of your business. None of your business. You're allowed to mention work, but not directly. You're allowed to say, listen, people work here. It's up to you. That's the furthest you could go. This is what goes on all over this country. Black people can get away with anything. If you're a Muslim, you could get away with anything. If you're a woman, you could get away with anything. White people could get away. Do you ever have a white person make it in a civil rights movement or any kind of a movement where he steals television sets? What has that got to do with civil rights? If you steal a television set, if you happen to be white, you go to jail for 30 years. If you're a black person who steals 10,000 television sets, it's called a civil rights movement. What has civil rights movement got to do with stealing television sets from a Korean storekeeper? Did he persecute you? When is the last time you saw Koreans persecuting black people? They thank God they're alive. They work like horses in the middle of the night in a store. And all of a sudden, whoo-hoo, they became a menace to society because they happened to sell television sets. That's why I say, let's get true equality in America. It's about time we got equality for Catholics and Jews and white people and tall people, and the majority should be protected against the minority. It used to be the minority that was frightened of the majority. Now it's just the opposite. There's no protection for the majority from the minority. Go figure this out.